I know it's been a minute since I posted my last video, and in that video I didn't even say like who I was or anything. I just jumped right into it. But I'm Renee. I go by the nickname Ree. I'm 26 and I was born and raised in Chicago, Illinois, and I currently reside in Chicago. So in this video, I'm pretty much going to talk about what it's like working in the healthcare field. And how I pretty much started off in the healthcare field and became a CNA / nurse tech. So once I graduated from out of high school, I went straight to college. I started at a community college. I didn't go away to a university. I started at Olive Harvey College, just on 103rd and Woodline. So as I was taking classes there, I ended up taking up the CNA course. It was a school out in Dalton. So that's where I took the CNA class at. And along with the CNA class came clinicals as well. I think we only had clinicals like one day out the week. So with clinicals, it's basically like you can either have clinicals at a hospital or you can have clinicals at a nursing home. And that's pretty much where you get your hands-on training with patients as well. So once I completed the CNA course, I received the certificate. After that, I set for the state board. I passed it the first time around. Once I passed, that's when I started filling out applications for jobs in the healthcare field. And my first job was like at a nursing home. Yeah, you can pretty much say it was like a nursing home. It's where my aunt worked, my mom's sister, and she's a nurse as well. She's an LPN, and that's licensed practical nurse. She's been a nurse, I want to say probably like over 10 years, if I'm not mistaken. But the first job I had was working at her job, which her best friend was the DON. So she ended up hiring me there. She was the one who actually told me that I passed my state board because she looked it up. So I was excited. So I started there. I worked in other nursing homes as well. I did home health care before. I did it for my grandmother before she passed away. Once she passed away, I started working in a hospital, which was my first hospital job. I mean, it wasn't too bad. The pay could be a little bit better, I can say that. But other than that, you know, just getting the experience is what really counts. So, you know, if I choose to go somewhere else or something like that, it's like, you know, I would have that I can, you know, use as a stepping stone. You know, I could put it on my resume. So it's like, you know, you just got to start somewhere. So, yeah. In the healthcare field, you will see a lot of things. And one thing I want to say, like, if this is really not something that you can see yourself doing, you know, as a career, like, don't get involved in it. Like, don't let anyone else pressure you into going into, like, the, you know, healthcare field or anything like that. Like, whatever it is, whether you're doing, like, phlebotomy, doing CNA, nursing, physician, if it's not something you really want to do and because you like helping people, I would not say just to go into it, especially not just going into it for the money. Like, don't do that. Like, whatever it is that you really want to do, follow your dreams, you know, achieve your goals. That's what I will tell you all. But if you're going to be in this particular field, I will tell you to, you know, further your education. You have places that will help you pay for school if you choose to go back. You know, it's places that do tuition reimbursement. Like, if you work at certain hospitals, they will help you pay for school if you choose to go back and further your education, which is a good thing to do. Me, I have had my experience with being in nursing school. I'm currently about to go back to school as well. Which I'm like so ready. I'm so ready to go. So yeah, I'm gonna do a video on that too soon. Yeah, I'm trying to do it soon. But another thing I wanna discuss is how I really don't like how people like try to down talk CNAs. Like, there's nothing wrong with being a CNA / nurse tech or PCT, what the hospitals label them as. PCTs or nurse techs. Like, it's nothing wrong with it. Like, never be ashamed to say what you do. Like, is this something that you love doing or whatever? Like, me personally, like, during my years or whatever, being a CNA, like, I was never ashamed to tell people, like, oh, yeah, you know, I'm a CNA, you know, this is what I do, you know, I help people and stuff, because you have so many people that cannot do for themselves and don't have family members around to help them or, you know, to care for them. And it's because, like, a lot of times too, like, their family members don't want to be bothered, but will, like, try to use them for, like, money and stuff. So it's kind of sad in a way. So, you know, and then just seeing a look on someone's face when you take the time out and be there, like, sometimes they just want somebody to talk to and stuff. So, you know, seeing that reaction that they, you know, get and they give to you once, you know, you took the time out to just listen to them or to help them, like, it's a good feeling. It's a great feeling. It really is. So, yeah, that's what I wanted to say. As far as, like, you know, little remarks and stuff people make and try to say, oh, they don't make nothing, this, that, and third. That's not true. People that's been in the field, you know that's not true and stuff like that. And even if it was, like, so what? At least you have a job. There's some people out here that's cool with being fucking bums. They ain't got no job but want to talk. So, yeah. When it comes to, like, the work place, like, the environment and stuff, like, what I will say is, like, don't get caught up in BS, because I'm pretty sure y'all all know the drama that goes on in the workplace, at your job. Like, don't even get involved in that and stuff like that. And you have some people that's, like, willing to help you with your workload, because this can be, like, a very stressful workload or whatever like that. Like, your workload can be stressful. You can be tired, like, drained and stuff, because you have so much on your plate. And as we know, like, the ones that work in the healthcare field and stuff like that, we tend to fall, like, short staff. So you can be, like, short CNAs or short of nurses. So you have so many patients that you have to do for that's relying on you. So that can be really stressful. Like, I can't even sit here and say how many times, like, I probably wasn't able to take a break or was on my feet for hours. But I'm like, whatever, I got the job done. I didn't mind helping the next person as well. And that's another thing, like, teamwork, you know, they're real big on teamwork. Like, you should not be trying to do this, like, by yourself. It helps, like, everybody pull together and work as a team. Not trying to say, oh, well, I'm not doing this for that person, I'm not doing that. Especially if it's something so little. Like, don't be petty. Like, don't. Like, I can't stand with people like that. Like, I really don't like working with people that's like that. Like they too good to do this and that. Like, my thing be, why are you here then? You know? Like, goodbye. But yeah, you tend to run across some of those type of people. And then you tend to run across some good people, you know, good hearted people that you tend to click with and stuff that make you want to come to work and stuff like that. So that's a good thing. That's, you know, it outweighs the bad. The good should always outweigh the bad. But yeah, what I was about to say, like, I recently got invited to a annual dinner. So a lot of jobs usually had it. So, like, in them tickets, they do be, like, expensive, like $300 and up, like $3,000 and stuff. But I got invited to one, and I did go. I do have pictures, like, on my Instagram and Facebook of me with my black dress on. I looked real nice. I did. So that was an experience. You know, you get to meet people who you probably normally don't get a chance to talk to, probably don't even know work at the same facility as you. So, you know, that's a great experience as well. So if you do have that opportunity to attend one, go right on ahead. You know, get dressed up, you know, have you a couple of drinks. You know, they be having, like, open bar for, like, an hour, which they need not to, because people do like to drink. They do. But that's pretty much all I really had to say. Oh, something else. Yes, when it comes to this type of job, yes, you do have to, you will come across some people you have some people that have mobility that can still get around, and you have some people that are immobile, like, you know, they really can't do for themselves. So you would have to assist a lot, and sometimes they be like total care, can't do anything. Some can do some things and probably just need some assistance, and then you have some that can't do nothing. So you have to, you know, feed them, bathe them, groom them, clothe them, you know, just everything, and taking vital signs, period. Unless you work somewhere where they don't need them, I guess. But yes, it comes time where you might have to wipe ass, okay? Yes, it happens. If you don't do it, who will do it? They can't do it. So, you know, you're not gonna just leave them messed up. So, you know, I like people that don't mind doing the work. You know, doing what we gotta do to get the job done. Like, even if it may not be a patient, like, if you're just helping someone out, like, it doesn't hurt. It doesn't. So just, you know, try to come in with a positive attitude. Like, don't be all snobby and stuff, like, because it just makes people, like, not want to be around you, don't want to work with you and stuff like that. And don't let other people, you know, negativity and stuff rub off on you. Just don't. Just ignore people. And for the ones that try to, like, make, you know, little smart-ass comments about what you do, try to down-talk what you do and stuff like that, let their ass talk. They ain't nobody, if they even got a goddamn job themselves, not trying to live off somebody else, or got a motherfucker taking care of them because they too lazy to get out here and work. Like, don't pay that no mind. Like, motherfuckers gonna talk whether you doing bad or good. And some people can just hate on you. Like, when they see, you know, you doing your thing, you independent, and you continuing to further, you know, go further in life, like, yeah, people will hate, even the ones that's closer to you. So watch out for that. When they be making their little slick comments, whole time motherfuckers be throwing shade. So just be on the lookout for that shit. But don't let it deter you from what you're doing. Continue to do you shit. Live your best life, boo. That's what I will say. But I'm not going to hold y'all up. I just wanted to, you know, let y'all know a little bit about me. I'm going to have more videos for you all, you know, just telling you more about me, sharing my thoughts and feelings about things. So, you know, just continue to stay in tune.